Hello and welcome back to Global with me, Matthew Amerewaller. Now, 30 years ago, the pop star Bob Geldof put together a collection of the world's biggest artists to record the Band-Aid signal to the single Do They Know It's Christmas? Its purpose was to raise money for the victims of Ethiopia's devastating famine. Well, now he's put together a new group, including stars such as One Direction, Ed Sheeran and Chris Martin, for an updated version to raise funds for the fight against Ebola. But it sparked a debate about whether this is the best way to help West Africa combat a disease which has now killed more than 5,000 people. What a question we will tackle in just a moment. First, this report from our correspondent, Lizo Mizimba.
It's Christmas time. There's no need to be afraid.
Even before it went on sale this morning, the new version of Do They Know It's Christmas had raised in excess of $1 million purely through people pre-ordering the track.
And in our world, our plenty.
That figure is expected to rise significantly, and the song is heavily tipped to reach number one in the UK this weekend. All the money raised will be used to help fight the Ebola crisis in West Africa. The man behind the single, Bob Geldof, says that people across the UK want to help and that musicians should do the same.
You can see that in the thousands of young boys and girls from the National Health Service who volunteered to go down and help. You know, the boys and girls in the army, young kids, volunteering to go down. So it seems always to be a national effort. And the least the pop people can do is to bang the drum and get everybody else involved.
According to the World Health Organization, the Ebola crisis has claimed around 5,000 lives in West Africa. Many experts believe that's an underestimate and that the real figure is far higher. Similar fundraising singles are also set to be recorded in the US, France and Germany, with the organizers hoping that such a coordinated international effort will raise both money and awareness and make a real difference. Lizo Mizimba, BBC News.
Well, as Lizo was mentioning there, there are other musical efforts being used in the fight against Ebola. So which are the best equipped to do that, and should they be focusing on raising money or awareness? Well, one of those records is Africa Stop Ebola, which is a collaboration between some of Africa's biggest music stars. Its producer is Carlos Chirinos, and he's here with me, as is the music promoter Harvey Goldsmith, who's also a trustee of the Band-Aid Trust charity. Welcome both to the programme here. Carlos, to you, first of all, you're critical in part of this Band-Aid record. Tell me why.
Well, we believe that any efforts to raise money for the cause are valid. However, these come at a cost. And the cost is the type of lyrics and the type of narrative that is being built around the Ebola crisis and the way it is portraying West Africa.
What do you mean by that?
So the lyrics, in a way, do not represent what West Africa is. In effect, it's portraying Africa or West Africa as a place ridden with death and all sorts of different values that do not necessarily represent what the entirety of Africa is. And this goes back to the original song, that we don't see the impact, the broad impact of, that the song had on trade, on tourism, and the way it is affecting the image of Africa around the world.
How do you respond to that?
I don't agree with that at all. The fact that that the artist community, particularly out of the UK and across the world, come together to help deal with a crisis, and it is a crisis, which can have global implications. I mean, the fact of life is that this isn't a crisis that's just instilled into Africa. Anybody getting on a plane, health workers coming in and out, people travelling across Africa, this is going to hit us, and it's the first time that something of this nature has ever happened. And the fact that we've come together to help do this from the original idea of us watching simple pictures on TV of people starving when we were discussing what to do with butter and fruit mountains, we've come together to try and help. And
Carlos, where is Harvey wrong then in that assessment, that defence of this?
I think it's very valid to try to raise money, but we are repeating an old way to sort out problems, which is throw money at the problem and it will go away. And what we are trying to tackle here is the origin of the problem. The origin of the problem is the disease and how it is contagiousness, how it is passing.
But without money, without help, without healthcare workers, without medicines to deal with the issue, It's not going to get solved. You can talk about it.
Do you not accept that point? Because, I mean, the UN have been trying to raise awareness. They've also been trying to raise money and are struggling with both. Yeah. This potentially can raise millions. Do you not accept that?
Yes. The money sent... This is the image, right? The money serves as a purpose, which is to send firemen to put out a fire. Now, we're not tackling the origin of the fire, which is behaviours. Behaviours associated with...
At the moment, the fire is raging.
No, it's not raging. It is bad. It is bad, but 5,000 people dead. It is getting out of control. But the main issue is how to tackle the origin of the disease, which is behavioral.
You've got to deal with the disease. The disease is containable.
No, that's out of fear. That's out of fear of coming to the UK or coming to Europe or coming to the US.
It's not out of fear. It's a practical issue that's happening in those countries. And what we want to do is to try and stop that spreading.
The origin of the problem is in Africa.
We want to try and stop it spreading in Africa, because if it stops spreading in Africa, it will then stop spreading the rest of the world. Of course, it's a knock-on effect. But our primary motivation is the minimum of 5,000 people dying. That's not acceptable.
Carlos, you talked about changing the lyrics. In this version, the lyrics have been changed. And so Bob Geldof was making the point that actually this disease is unlike any other sort of disease, because you die alone. Loved ones can't actually touch you for fear of actually contracting it themselves. Now, doesn't that get across just the absolute horror of this disease? So, again, in part, it's worth doing it for that reason, is it not?
As I said, it's worth doing it for the money, and the money is needed. However, it comes at a cost, and the cost is the way in which Africa is being portrayed to the rest of the world. Now, this is going to have a knock-on effect on tourism, on trade, which is the reason why, for instance, up to today, still we think, or the West thinks, that Ethiopia is famine because of a song.
That is not true. Everybody started to accept, finally, that Africa is the fastest, the youngest growing continent in the whole world. There are a bigger middle class. 7 to 10 of the cities in Africa, the fastest growing cities. There's a middle class going up. Communications. All these things are happening partly because of the efforts we made to pay attention.
Well, Carlos disagrees with you. Now, you were making the point, Carlos, that you don't think this particular version of this song is particularly helpful. You have done your own version. Before we pick up with that, let's just play a little bit of it so viewers can have a see of what you did. So that is just a brief flavour. Why is that more legitimate than what Sir Bob Geldof has put together?
First of all, I didn't make the song myself. It's a collaboration of 12 of the best West African artists. And they were concerned about what the Ebola crisis is, the way it is affecting their own countries. At the same time, the lyrics are conveying a message of prevention. The only way in which Ebola is going to be stopped is through prevention.
But that's public information rather than raising awareness.
It is public information.
Are you missing the point in terms of what this is about?
This is about raising money. That's what Bob Geldof repeats over and over. We need your money. We don't care if you like the song.
But you need money for the health centers,
indeed,
the doctors, the nurses.
But it's to send more firemen to put out the fire. We're not sending people, or we're not sending the message to stop the origin of the fire.
Harvey, we've had a big response to both the record and also the debate. Let me just read a few things on Facebook, because Tracy or Sarah from Tunisia says, this is ridiculous, it's outdated, no more Band-Aid, please. Please stop embarrassing yourself. Another one from Teresa who says, where will the money go? How do we know it goes to the really affected areas?
Well, very simply, with the money, we're a very fast response organisation. We don't have any overhead, so we dish the money out as it comes in. And the money will go out to those organisations that tell us where that money is most needed. That's our prime responsibility. Raise the money, collect it, and give it to where it's most needed. Whether it's for prevention, whether it's for to build hospitals, whether it's to help get more healthcare workers and doctors out there, we will take that on advice. But what we will do is, instead of having to deal with a bureaucracy, that money will go out as soon as it comes in on the
advice
we're given.
We're almost out of time. Just a sentence from both of you, really quickly. Are these sorts of records still valid 2014?
Without a shadow of a doubt, both what you're doing and what we're doing, they're different sides of the coin.
Carlos?
They're both relevant.
I think the effort is needed. I think the song is out of date. I think the message in the song is not really tackling what it's needed, which is rebuild the image of Africa, and so the West understands Africa.
Right.
It doesn't think.
That's for you.
We
do.
Have to leave it there. Harvey, yeah. Carlos,
thanks
both of you for arguing and debating this here on Global. Thanks very much.